Hi everybody, Chef Dustin Stone here with this month's episode of Cooking with Food Pro. Today we're going to do a different take on an American classic, steak and eggs. The star of this month's show is Food Pro item number 86319, which is an 8-ounce flat iron steak from Holton. The product comes in individually cryovac and frozen. We've just slacked it out here. It is a choice product. You can see the beautiful marbling in here, which is going to make it extra tender and juicy for your customers. We're going to take some home fries, top that with some caramelized onions. We're going to blacken the flat iron steak, put that on top, finish it with some poached eggs and hollandaise sauce. So we're going to start with the home fries because we want to get those nice and brown. It's going to take a little bit longer. I got some whole butter here. We use lots of it because butter makes everything better. Nice hot pan. Get that melted, coat the bottom of the pan here. Sliced raw potatoes here. A little bit of salt and pepper. And when you're seasoning potatoes, it's okay to be liberal with that stuff. It's very hard to over-season potatoes. You want to make sure that your dish is seasoned properly. I'm going to give it a little toss. Make sure that they get coated in the butter real good. And that way you can forget about it. You want to get those nice and brown. It's going to give it a little bit of texture to the plate, and it's also going to look really nice. So now while our potatoes are browning, we're going to go ahead and make the hollandaise. Now, hollandaise is sometimes intimidating for folks, but with the use of a food processor, it can be very easy. We're going to make a 6-yolk hollandaise. I got here 6 egg yolks. I got 2 tablespoons of lemon juice. Give it a little bit of acid. And couple dashes of Tabasco. Now maybe more to come. Now the key to this is we have to use hot clarified butter. Alright, that's going to help cook the yolks and make sure that there's no foodborne illnesses in there. Just going to turn on my handy dandy food processor, get it going. Take this hot clarified butter. Now this is an emulsification, so we got to drizzle it in real slow so that it doesn't break. And what we're doing is we're taking a fat and emulsifying it into an acid. Lemon juice being the acid, butter being the fat. Very slowly. Make sure I get it all. I'm going to season it with some salt and pepper. A little bit of cayenne. it up, mix it. And voila. Now we're going to take the hollandaise sauce. I have a pot of hot water back here. That's going to keep it warm, but not hot. If it gets too hot, it'll break. Meanwhile, you see my potatoes are getting nice and brown. I've got our flat iron steak and I'm liberally coating it in this blackened seasoning. We use Cajun seasoning for this. I happen to like the Paul Prudhomme one. It's nice and coated. Again, I'm waiting for this pan to get super hot, almost to the smoking point. So now our pan's getting really hot and you can see the smoke coming off of there. I'm just gonna take this steak, put it in that part of the pan there. I'm gonna dump my onions in here. I wanna cook those in the same pan as I'm cooking the steak, because any of this blackened seasoning is going to help flavor the oil, which is going to help flavor the onions, which is going to bring the whole dish together. All right, so now these onions are already starting to brown a little bit. I'm going to toss them, make sure that they don't burn, they get coated in the oil. We're going to let that go for a couple minutes. I'm going to turn the heat down now that the pan's hot. I wish you could smell how nice it smells. There I go, I'll give my potatoes a stir here. Those are really browning nicely. If I cook everything in the same pan, it's going to help bring all these flavors together again. My onions are now soft. They've got a nice color to them. I'm going to move them over here to the potato pan. So I don't want to get them done. Too done. That nice and coated. Turn that heat up a little bit. Again, it smells so nice. Alright, and if you look around the edges here, you can see it's starting to get nice and dark. I'm going to go ahead and flip it. It's got a nice caramelized steak there. Walk it up. And we're going to go for a couple minutes on the other side. So now, we've got it good on both sides. You can see that. I'm going to set it over here to rest. Now we're ready to poach our eggs. What I got here is some hot water. You don't want it to boil. You just want to get it hot. What we're going to do now is we're going to put some lemon juice liberally. Lemon juice doesn't cost very much. That's going to help flavor our eggs and bring that hollandaise sauce together with it. And it's also going to react with the amino acids in the egg whites, which is going to hold them together a little bit better. So what I've done here is I've just cracked two eggs into these containers here. That's going to make it easier for me to dump it into the poaching liquid without breaking the yolks. And you can see part of that yolk is sticking up out of the liquid. I'm going to cover it with a lid here so that the top gets done as well. After a couple minutes, You can see our eggs are nice and poached. And again, that lemon juice is going to help hold them together there. And now we're ready to plate. So plate this thing. I'm going to take my nice flat iron. It's nice and rested. Put it on the cutting board. I'm going to start off. Base, a nice home fries, healthy portions. I'm going to put our caramelized onions on top of that. Bias. Nice medium rare. You can see how easy it is to slice because it's nice and tender. I'll put that on top of everything. Slotted spoon to remove our poached eggs. Drain off any excess liquid. Put that right on top of there. Pretty tall. There we go. Our hollandaise sauce that we prepared. Oh, salt and pepper. Don't forget seasoning. Put that on top. A little bit of fresh chopped flat leaf parsley. And I'm going to garnish it with a parsley leaf. And if you're going to use fresh herbs for a garnish, I'd suggest you put it in a container with some ice water. That's going to crisp them up and make them nice and shiny. You can see how nice that is right on top. And voila. It's a different take on an American classic steak and eggs using the Holton Flatiron Steak. Thanks for cooking with Food Pro.